Morning.
It's a beautiful morning. My first choice for this morning would have been to be cycling, but I did a little bit of that yesterday. So I decided this is the second best thing I will do this afternoon, this morning. So why DTM? An analogy of cycling, because there's a lot of parallels for me in cycling and teamwork as in Toastmasters. But there's a better one that comes up, and you'll hear about it in a few seconds. The route I was going to go for this presentation would have been a disaster if it wasn't for an influential Toastmaster who woke me up and said, no, you should talk about what does Toastmasters lead you with? Sorry, what does the DTM process lead you with? And I thought, great, that's a great idea. Some members come to Toastmasters to enhance their speaking skills, because we are primarily known as a speaking volunteer organization. We come to speak. There are some, though, that come to enhance their leadership skills. And we can do both of those quite well. And I decided to bring my plaque, but I zoned out my name because it's not about me, it's about you. Your name belongs up there. The example I best use is from when I was a kid growing up in Parkland, Manitoba. We spend a lot of our times outside in the wilderness, picking mushrooms, looking at the animals, going through the lakes, canoeing, hiking. And in the spring, the rivers were massively full. There was no way you could cross it. But later in the year, later in summer, we would revisit those same favorite rivers. And lo and behold, the water level drops, and there's rocks that appear. And we as kids would always try and say, how can we cross the river? How can we challenge ourselves? And you look at the river in one spot, and you see rocks randomly placed, big, small, slippery, high, jagged, smooth. And you start to look at, which way can I make it across the river, a pathway? And I thought, this is like the DTM. The DTM is a process, I realized. DTM is a process that merges two things. It merges your speaking side, and it merges your leadership side. And sometimes you don't realize it until you're halfway through it, you're three-quarter way through it, and then you start to see that that is what's happening. Merging those two genres together. And I realize DTM is a process, not only a process, but that word pathway keeps coming up. I don't know why. Does anyone know why? It's a pathway. And there's multiple pathways that each and every one of you can pick to attain your DTM. There's a lot of flexibility in that pathway. So after a number of years, the Toastmaster will do one of two things. Some will stay and they'll plateau and they'll just try and keep up with what they've achieved, what they've learned, try to keep those skills at bay. And sadly, there's the other ones who leave Toastmasters. And they think they're ready for the world. So they leave. Now, up until August 2011, Toastmasters was known principally as a speaking organization. But in Vegas in 2011, August 2011, their convention rebranded to Where Leaders Are Made. They put leadership front and center. So that Toastmasters is now known to be the leading authority on leadership development worldwide. So when everybody joins Toastmasters, they have a different view of where they're going to go. And, you know, the funny thing is, I look back at myself and I realize, you know, when I joined Toastmasters back in Winnipeg in 1986, 87, I believe, with one club next to another club, I thought, you know, speaking is taught in one room and leadership is taught in another room, or even a building, or in different cities, that the two are mutually exclusive. And in reality, nothing could be further from the truth, because if you're a good speaker, you're a good leader. And if you're a good leader, you speak well. They eventually merge in your pathway to achieving your DTM. They will come together. So I started to jot down a few of the things that I just hope I have enough time, but I'll try and keep it within the time limit. Some of the things that I realized that my pathway to attaining my DTM taught me. First and foremost is speaking skills. How to come up here, how to speak off the cuff, table topics, keynotes, to be relaxed. When I got my first, when I received my first CTM, which is called CTM back then, today Competent Toastmaster, somebody asked me, what were you before? And I said, well, I don't know, that's a good question. What were we before anything? And I said to her honestly, I said, I don't really know if I'm that much of a better speaker, But I'm certainly more relaxed. And when you're more relaxed, you can think clearer, you can think sharper, you can act better, and you bring out the best in yourself. One thing you'll learn is that you'll learn how to listen carefully to words people say. And sometimes when I'm driving down and listening to the radio, I will hear DJs make funny references to words, mispronounce words, and I wasn't even looking for it. It just happens. You're just listening to the words. That comes from our Toastmasters meetings. You will learn how to leverage topics, how to take one topic that you present at one club and turn it around and present it to another club or even an outside organization. Maybe at your work, maybe a volunteer group, your community association. You'll learn how to manage your time well. You'll learn how to take notes. There are some fantastic ideas that I came up with, thinking that, oh, I'll remember it when I get to work in 10 minutes. No. It never came back ever again. And now with the smartphone, that's a little easier because you can take audio notes. Taking notes, very, very important. It teaches you how to be compassionate and emphatic with your fellow members. Big part of leadership, learning how to listen. You will learn how to maybe sometimes resolve conflict resolution. And we don't see really conflicts that much in Toastmasters, but we do see differing of opinions. So you bring in the listening skills now and the observation, and you teach yourself gradually how to resolve differences, especially when you're a club executive. You'll learn how to ask the right questions. The right questions. I wonder sometimes when I ask a question and somebody answers, I ask the exact same question, they say a totally different thing. What does that tell me? It tells me they're not sure. Maybe I shouldn't have asked it. Sometimes they'll get upset. How to be cognizant of opportunities. You go to clubs and you see how they're doing things and what they need, and you'll right away see, I see an idea for an HPL. I see an idea for a youth leadership. You'll recognize problems and challenges very quickly. It's just second nature. You become observant of these. You'll learn how to team work. Very, very important. Last year when we were division directors, Christina Cruz built up her team by saying, Marshall, you be AD, Matt, you be AD, Teresa, you be AD, I'll be division. We'll make a team. They formed a nice team. That's the way to do it. You team build. And learn and grow and have fun by it. You'll learn how to give back. Big thing is the youth leadership. Giving back to the community. The couple that I've been involved with, the parents come up to you and absolutely love you. We did the last one at Matt in Ranchlands. Muslim Association of Calgary. And I met more of the parents than I think the participants, the youth participants. They'll love you. And you'll learn the different styles of leadership. I Googled it, and there's like 12 or 15 that come up. But the more prominent ones are autocratic, democratic, servant, and transformational. Autocratic, you make decisions on your own. Democratic, you involve your whole team. And you'll also learn how to use each one, and sometimes changing on the fly, day by day as needed. If you're a club exec and the district needs a decision from you ASAP, you go autocratic. You decide quickly and then you inform your team what you decided and why. If you have a week or more, you go democratic. You tell your team what's happening, you want their input, you use it as a team. You can learn how to switch leadership styles on the fly. And you can pick which one you are best suited to by your genre, by your character. And you learn to see how complementary the leadership and the speaking side is. So eventually you realize that the leadership side and the speaking side are not really that far apart. In fact, they're mutually inclusive. They become one and the same. You can't have one without the other. It's just how it works. A leader has to be a good speaker. So that, going back to that river and those rocks, each and every one of you can pick your own path of how to cross that river and get to the other side, the same side, and achieve your DTM. It's your pathway to merging your two sides, building up your leadership and speaking skills. Don't underestimate the value. Go all the way, become a DTM ambassador. I have a few handouts on one of the tables that you can get later. There's a really nice program charting course. I didn't print enough of them, but you can download them from the Calgary Advanced website, public folder download, where you chart all your modules of your DTM. And you do not have to do them in order. That's something that isn't really told people that much, but really, in truth, you don't. If you see an opportunity for youth leadership, grab it. If you see an opportunity to do speeches, to fill up one of your advanced manuals, do it. And then chart it down on your paper so that you do not lose track of that. The nice thing is, any credits earned with Toastmasters, you never ever lose them. So if you have to leave for a while for some reason, they will always be there. But don't underestimate the value of that DTM. Get your name on that file. If there's any questions, I'll be glad to answer them later. I know we're running a bit behind. That's a very, very important point. What hit me was you start to see how to give back, like through youth leadership, through club coaching, through coaching several members in your club. You learn how to give back. And that's another big reason why I think the Toastmasters program is so successful, because now you've become more as a leader. Now you want to pull people up to your ranks. Maybe you won't repeat being an area director or division director, but you will coach somebody who is, and you will shadow them and say to them, I'll help you whenever you need help. So very important point, it's about giving back. And I think that's another big attribute of the Toastmasters program.